And they were there with the wind, and they crumble in your hand. I threw a pebble in a brook and watched the ripples run away, and they never made a sound, and the leaves that are
amongst my many neuroses, there was a time when I couldn't bear the thought of digging yourself. I thought that was the worst thing, to dig yourself, think that you were good, because if you did dig yourself, you never did anything naturally, and you're always worried about, was I cool, wasn't I cool, you know, type scenes. Tendency always to look in imaginary mirrors, see how you're coming out of every situation. So during the depths of this neurosis, I'm like shaving with my eyes closed, you know, see myself. One day, I walk down Broadway in New York, and where Broadway crosses 52nd Street, there's a drugstore that has a black plate glass window. Very clearly, you can see a reflection in it, you see, if you are of the nature to seek out your reflection in drugstore windows. And so, anyway, I look and pow, there I am. So, I was shocked. I hadn't seen myself in about a year. You know, so I was, you know, truth be told, I was digging myself for about 45 seconds, an intense dig, see? When this bird that was perched overhead, like, total disregard for me, just, he defecated on me. Now, I don't know if this has ever happened to you, but if it has, you know that it is virtually impossible to maintain your cool under those circumstances. Right? And all I can think of, you know how thoughts race through your mind, moments of crises, whoosh. All I can think of is like, there goes a happy bird. It's like, gone, you know. And then I'm fantasizing, I'm saying, can you imagine this bird sort of floating about the city of New York for a week, you know, like looking for a place to land, like saving up, you know, and then pow, and don't dig yourself. Relative to nothing, this is a song called Sparrow.
Ooh.
of the oak tree. I won't share my branches with no sparrow's nest, and my blanket of leaves won't warm her cold breast. If the other swans heard, and who will take pity in his heart, and who will feed a starving sparrow? Not I, said the golden leaf. I need all my grain to prosper and grow. I'm sitting in the railway station, got a ticket for my destination. On a tour of one night stands, my suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. And every stranger's face I see reminds me that I long to be homeward bound. I wish I was homeward bound. Home, when my thoughts escape and home, when our music's playing home, when our love lies waiting silently for me. Tonight I'll sing my songs again. Like emptiness in harmony, I need someone to comfort me. Homeward bound, I wish I was homeward bound. you love me? You don't know, but I know that you do. You may think you're above me, yeah. What you think isn't always true. Don't try to debate me. You should know that I'm womanly wise. Still you're trying to hallucinate me. You don't know where your interest lies. No, you don't know where your interest lies. You don't begin to comprehend. You're just a game that I like to play. You may think that we're friends, all right, but I won't let friendship get in my way. No, I won't let friendship get in my way. Called A Most Peculiar Man. It's a song that I wrote when I was living in London, and the seeds of the song were planted one day when I read an article in the paper about a man who had committed suicide. You see? Four lines in the paper, little black box and such, and I thought that was a very bad eulogy, you see. So this is called A Most Peculiar Man.
He was a most peculiar man. That's what Mrs. Reardon says, and she should know. She lived upstairs from him. She said he was a most peculiar man. He was a most peculiar man. He lived all alone within a house, within a room, within himself. Most peculiar man. He had no friends, he seldom spoke, and no one in turn ever spoke to him, 'cause he wasn't friendly and he didn't care, and he wasn't like them. Oh no, he was a most peculiar man. Died last Saturday. He turned on the gas and he went to sleep with the windows closed, so he'd never wake up to his silent world in his tiny room. And Mrs. Reardon says he has a brother somewhere who should be notified soon. And all the people said, what a shame that he's dead. But wasn't he a most peculiar man?
Paul's just finished a song this week. It's now the 26th Paul Simon song in the collection, almost all of which we have recorded somewhere or another on single or on album. There is one fairly notable exception which we would like to do. It's a song that was recorded first before we could get it down by a group called The Circle, who used to be good friends of ours. And they sold 890,000 copies of it. It's called Red Rubber Ball.
I should have known you'd bid me farewell. There's a lesson to be learned from this, and I learned it very well. Now I know you're not the only starfish in the sea. I'll never hear your name again, it's all the same to me. And I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. Morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. You never cared for secrets I confide. To you I'm just an ornament, something for your bride. Always running, never caring, that's the life you live. Stolen minutes of your time were all you had to give. And I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. Morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. This story's in the past with nothing to recall. I've got my life to live and I don't need you at all. The roller coaster ride we took is nearly at an end. I bought my tickets with my tears, that's all I'm gonna spend. And I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. Whoa, I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball. Whoa, it's not so nice. It's shining like a red rubber ball.
Hey, you're a gas. I like to do the dangling conversation for you. This is the song that is about our favorite amongst all the songs, and it took us the longest time to record in the studio, and it took Paul the longest time of all the songs to write. This is the dangling conversation.
Superficial side. eyes are the borders of our lives. Yes, we speak of things that matter with words that must be said. Can analysis be worthwhile? Is the theater really dead? How the room is softly faded, and I only kiss your shadow. I cannot feel your hand. You're a stranger now unto me, lost in the dangling conversation and the superficial sighs in the borders of our lives.
I came back from England to the United States in December of 1965. The Sounds of Silence had become a big hit, and I returned, you see, and I had to make this transition from being relatively unknown in England to a sort of semi-famous type here. And I didn't adjust well. It was always slightly embarrassing to me, teeny bops, etc. I used to think, gee, all my sweets are gone, good times gone, left over in England, and all the songs I was writing, very down type of songs, nothing happy. And until about last June, for some reason, last June, I started to come out of it. I started to get into a good mood. I don't know why. One day, I was riding along in my Aston Martin, and I said to myself, I really don't have an Aston Martin. In fact, I don't have any car at all. I was the type of kid, when I was in Paris, we would sit on the banks of the Seine in Paris, and when the tourist boats would go by, you know, I would yell out, "Capitalist pig." I don't know. Last June, that's right. So here I am, getting into this pleasant frame of mind, and I was coming home one morning about 6 o'clock in the morning, and coming over the 59th Street Bridge in New York, and what a groovy day it was, a real good one. And one of those times when you know you're not going to be tired for about an hour, you know, it's going to be nice. So I started writing a song, which later became the 59th Street Bridge song, or Feeling Groovy. Red lights, I applaud you. It's really so Pavlovian, isn't it? It's... really nice. Red lights really remind me of such groovy times. Eh? Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last. Just kicking down the cobblestones, looking for fun and feeling groovy. Da 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 da.
is growing. Ain't you got no rhymes for me? Do it do do, feeling groovy. No deeds to do, no promises to keep. I'm dappled and drowsy and ready to sleep. Let the morning time drop all its petals on me. Life, I love you, all is groovy.
Notice that we do that song a little bit faster than they do.
I don't have to live up to that version.
This is a song that's an adaptation of an Edwin Arlington Robinson poem written some years back called Richard Cory. University now. for about 7 years. I'm in the graduate school there now, but when I was an undergraduate, I took quite a few music courses, one of which got me very involved in 16th century music. And I researched one week in the library a two-part setting of a Benedictus from the church mass, originally done by Orlando de Lasso, and brought it for the two of us to do. We rewrote the two parts and added guitar chords to it and put it into our first album for Columbia. So this is our version of Benedictus.
London called Soho. Soho is roughly equivalent to Greenwich Village in New York. And it has a lot of coffee houses, folk clubs, beat clubs. See? And I work there often, and I used to go to see friends, you know, who are working there. So I was in and out of Soho very, very often. One day I got caught in a downpour, and I stepped inside St. Anne's Cathedral, which is on a little park in Soho, St. Anne's Cathedral. And I was impressed with a sermon that I heard being delivered. What impressed me was that it didn't say anything, nothing. When you walked out of there, it didn't make any difference whether you walked in unless you dug stained glass, you know? Because the meek are inheriting nothing, nothing. And that's the basis of this song called Blessed.
the meek, for they shall inherit. Blessed is the Lamb whose blood flows. Blessed are the sat upon, spat upon,
place to go. I've walked around Soho for the last night or so. Ah, but it doesn't matter. No, no, no.
Blessed is the land and the king.
An album. It's the first one we made for Columbia. It's called Wednesday Morning, 3 a.m., and it features on the cover Paul and myself standing in the shadows of love, standing in the subways in New York City, next to an iron post. If you're familiar with the cover, you know that we're both wearing business suits, standing as the train is about to come in. It happens that on the day that we took the pictures, we took about 400 shots, not of that pose, but of the two of us both leaning against the subway wall, which is right off camera range, as you see it on the final shot. And we took all these poses and spent the entire afternoon leaning against this wall until we were pleased with the shot that we thought we were going to use, and packed up our cameras and guitars and began to head out of the subway, when I took a brief parting glance at the subway wall in front of which we had taken all the pictures for the first time that day, and noticed that written rather legibly in the Baroque style of New York City subway wall writers was the old familiar suggestion. And It was a beautiful illustration that went with it. So we had 400... We had 400 choices for an album cover, and all not acceptable. So that was the beginning of the theme, which has crept into several of the songs, of people who write on subway walls. It's made an appearance in The Sounds of Silence, and it's become the theme of a song that went into our last album. The idea is that the people who do these things are, in some sense, writing a poem. And the sense is that what they are doing is expressing something that is very sincerely felt at the time, whether it be anger or whatever. But the point is, there's a reason why people do or do not do that sort of thing. The song is called A Poem on the Underground Wall.
Deserted station, restless in anticipation. A man waits in the shadows. His restless eyes leap and scratch all that they can touch or catch. Hidden deep within his pocket, safe within his silent socket, he holds a colored crayon. Now from the tunnel's stony womb, carriage rides to meet the groom and opens wide and welcome doors, but he hesitates, then withdraws deeper in the shadows. And the train has gone suddenly, on wheels clicking silently, like a gently tapping his honey, and he holds his crayon rosary. Flashes the crayon on the wall, he slashes deep upon the advertising. A single worded poem comprised of four letters, and his heart is laughing, screaming, pounding. The poem across the tracks rebounding, shadowed by the exit light. His legs take their ascending flight to seek the breast of darkness and be suckled by the night. Thank you. It's leaping in my memory. I won't disturb the slumber of feelings that have died. If I never loved, I never would have cried. I am a rock. I am an island. I have my books and my poetry to protect me. No pain, and an island there.
I must tell you this before I play the next song. Over there, hidden to me throughout most of the show, is a pitcher of water and four glasses. So when Artie was telling you about the Wednesday morning album cover, I was walking over there and I said, oh, here's a pitcher of water. Everybody who does concerts always takes a glass of water and they pour it out and they drink it. So I pick up the pitcher and I pour it all over my boot. Well, some people are show business, some people aren't. Here's a song that I wrote, and I'll play this, well, this is called For Emily Whenever I'm in Trouble.
Three hooded men, their hands lift a spark.
they faded in the night, vanished in the dark, in the cold light of morning. There's nothing that remains but the ashes of a Bible and a can of kerosene, and a church is burning. The flames rise higher, like hands that are praying, a glow in the sky. You can burn down my churches, but I shall be free. A church is more than just a red stone, and freedom is a dark road when you're walking it alone. But the future's now, it's time to take a stand, so the lost bells of freedom can ring out in my land. And a church is burning, flames rise higher, like hands that are praying, a glow in the sky. Like hands that are praying, the fire says, you can burn down my churches, but I shall be free.
Yeah.
Yet I know as I gaze at my young love beside me, the morning is just a